Alright, I got my new Bezgar 9 here. And the back suspension is great. It's got 4 shocks. But my new added 4200 milliamp hour 45C discharge rate battery is slumping these front shocks. There is no adjustment. Sometimes they have oil in them, sometimes they don't. So the way to stiffen these things up is to do some 80 weight or 100 weight silicone shock fluid. Use team associated. For style bashing, that's what you want, the real heavy stuff, the heavyweight. Usually, who knows what comes out of these, but Arma and the name brand stuff, I think usually use like 35 weight. So, since I can't put, there's no threads in here to tighten the spring, all I can do is make sure, well, I can already tell that the bottom seal is leaking. That's usually, these are loose. So, take the spring off. As I said, sometimes there's oil in the shock, sometimes there's not. Sometimes it's pour out, I have no idea what it is. They might put cooking oil on them for all I know. And without a doubt, this is always loose, and that's why they leak to start with. Yeah, see, I got about a quarter turn out of that. Spring off, that way I can bleed the shock before I put it back on. Make sure there's no air in it. And this is a pretty heavy truck. It's got a lot of metal skid plates under the control arms, and it's nicely built, so the back's fine. It supports the weight. It's the front. I don't want to land wrong and break the front dog bones or anything. Alright, it was full of oil. It looked like it was silicone too. The last one I did looked like used the oil off a lathe or something, or a CNC machine. If you've never put oil in a shock, make sure your piston's out. This stuff's like goo. Don't ever fill it all the way to the top, because remember the plunger in here is gonna come up. When it does that, there's no space for it, it'll end up blowing your seal out of the bottom fast. Bleed that, just make sure you don't go past the top of the oil. Get a couple bubbles. Once the bubbles stop, seal back on. through these one at a time too, that way in case you forget which way it came out, you've always got the other one to look at. Or you'll be pulling off a back shock. Given this had full oil, I just make sure the back shock, this part's tight, oil doesn't leak out. By having four shocks back there is more than sufficient. Back end of this truck's perfect. Rings that you can snap on here since it's not threaded and tighten the spring up. For some reason, we've got the Bezgar 6, it has these kind of shocks, and now the 9, and they don't supply any. I think the heavier. Nice red spring, looks good, but doesn't have much tension. I think putting a better shock wheel in it is a better answer than cranking down on the spring. The spring eventually will just get stop losing its rebound or pressure. Shock to do. It holds the tire to the ground. Oh yeah, look at that. Feels nice and tight. That's why when you put the real heavy 80 weight stuff in, when you get the impact, you know, if you're bashing and you get the impact, you know, your truck is not going to bottom out as easy and smash, you know, the bottom on the ground and start breaking things that way. Alright. You just pop on the bottom. And we got a screw for the top. Down here, I guess the front and the rear control arms are the same because they both have notches for two shocks on the lower. Obviously you can't put two on the front because you got a tie rod in the way. So that bottom just pops back on. Place it can go in the front. Trusty wild stick. Everything on here is Phillips. Alright, well number two is done the same way as the first one, so I'm not going to repeat that. Stop the camera, pour this one out, fill it up, charge this battery up, and then we're going to take it out for a drive.